Professor of Aesthetics Roger Scruton describes architecture as the meeting of the cult of art and the cult of utility. Architecture is a form of both high and low culture can be seen all around us. Unlike other forms of culture like art, music, and poetry, which we need to seek out, to discover, to engage with, architecture surrounds us. It is part of our environment. We have no choice but to encounter it, look at it, observe it. There have been efforts made to distinguish between high culture and low culture in architecture, but broadly speaking, high culture is represented by fine or high-end architecture, low culture by everyday forms of building. Scruton's concept of art and utility would, in equal measure, provide an ideal balance between form and function. It is, however, an ideal that is difficult to achieve. In the modern world of architecture, it is the cult of utility that is winning out, as function and fitness for purpose heavily outweigh the need for aesthetic value and beauty. Ardfert Cathedral dates back to the 12th century. It has survived many spates of plunder and pillage up to 1641, when it finally fell victim to the Cromwellite supporters and was burnt down. It was left beyond repair and leaving it in its present ruinous state. However, it has outlived its function and its form remains with us today. It stands testament to the incredible architecture and building skill employed to bring it to its original completion. The level of detail, the intricacy of the stonework, and the sheer scale of the building remains impressive today. Ballyseedy Castle is also an example of where function has been outlived by form. It was built around 1590 on the outskirts of Tralee and was the chief garrison of the legendary Fitzgeralds, the Earls of Desmond. It has been fought over, lived in, and admired by many, and carries forward its ancient grandeur to this day. The castle's interior has been renovated and it now operates as a 5-star hotel. It is the case of a historic building given a new function in its original form. The historical perspective on architecture has been abandoned in favour of the more modern view on how buildings should be constructed and what form they should take. Architecture has no longer a need for ornament or grandeur. Modern materials have been used to create the modern world. And the key element in all of this new architecture is form following function. It is the everyday forms of architecture with which we are most familiar and therefore most affected by. The recent proliferation of commercial and residential building in Ireland has had a devastating impact on the economy, the environment, and the physical and social landscape of the country. We built thousands of houses and apartments across the country in a frenzy of commercialisation and commodification, and it has backfired spectacularly. Ghost estates now litter the countryside, and audacious commercial buildings and empty factories lie idle in our towns and cities. Low-culture architecture has no aesthetic value and is devoid of beauty. The work of the architect is fundamental to the way the building takes its form and shape. The building will be in its chosen location and part of our landscape for a very long time. It is ultimately their choice, their design, their vision, along with a long-term commitment to the finished product. Sometimes the architect has to decide that certain aesthetics will have to be omitted from the design. Other times, it's elements of functionality that will be disregarded. In the design of many buildings, both the form and function will need to be compromised. It is at this point that the cult of art and the cult of utility meet.